The peace edict applies to all mortals, noble and common alike. That means...
Please leave me to my task.
Bother someone else.
I have arrived at last. Welcome to the Gardens of Issa, home of the Summer Court and the warm heart of the Feylands. I know you had hoped to speak with the High King, but our seers sense a danger pursuing you. Naturally, we cannot allow such threats to be brought into the High Court, perhaps once you have dealt with your own unfinished business. We are the Summer Court, the very embodiments of courage, honor, and all things bright and proud. Some envious few in the Winter Court would call us arrogant and self-righteous, as well as all manner of other epithets. But remember, we are the ones who stayed true to tradition, while they turned to barbarism. The Tuatha find new recruits from our ranks. Too many mortals misunderstand the Winter Court. Our cold cousins are not evil, but merely evoke the darker truths of nature, from subtlety to decay. Perhaps it makes sense that children of dust are put off by those who embody their inevitable death, but it is regrettable that so many are misunderstood. High King Tatarian is Lord of the Summerfey, the font of all our wisdom, and first amongst the immortals. And since Gadflow tragically murdered the High King of the Winter Court, Tatarian is the greatest and last true leader left of our kind. The sapling of the World Tree bears centuries of great wisdom. Of course, long-lived as Nirlam is, it is still regrettably mortal. Even all greatest mortal wisdom cannot compare to the perspective given by true agelessness. Begging your pardon, of course. The ranks of the Fae were not always sullied by the presence of anything so coarse as the Tuatha. Once, the Summer and Winter Courts existed in harmony. But Gadflow perverted the Winter Court with talk of his new god, and from that poison, the Tuatha arose. Truly a place of wonder, as it has always been and always shall be. Here springs the life well of Dalantarth, and the greater Feylands in all directions. It is a pity that some of our kind have fallen to such degenerative states, but we cannot shed a tear for their weakness.
Siolana for sagecrafting.
But the High King will only meet with those who have sought an audience. If you wish to gain permission, you will need to visit the Hall of Appointments.
Reyna Njorn can teach sagecrafting to anyone. She spends most of her time in the Delving Hall. Artan Cade is an expert at dispelling in the Rathia chapter.
Greetings. I have some ability with the art of sage crafting. Do you wish for some instruction? And the... What is this power? When many try to join our order, the Fae possess a certain communion with the magical energies of nature that we mortals can only dream of. Return when you wish to learn more.
Direct your attention to the trial, Initiate.
Concentrate on the task at hand.
This should not take long, but please hurry.
Center your thoughts on the trial to come. This is not as easy as it looks.
Greetings. Greetings. I will be the savant presiding over your trial of initiation. Traditionally, applicants have prepared for the challenges of this trial through years of study and training. But as Augra mentioned, we realize you are unique. Do you have any questions before we begin? The magic of the ritual confronts the applicant with his or her own potential. Consequently, no two experiences are the same. How this potential manifests varies. Whatever takes place is for the applicant only. Tradition dictates it is never spoken of. And a final warning. While whatever shape the magic takes isn't real, not truly, what happens can have real consequences. Do not underestimate the danger. This is a fluid magic. The form it takes varies according to the power and nature of the ritual's focus. In this case, you. The goal is a simple one. Survive. Like every Scholia Arcana member before you, to join our ranks, you must first confront the specter of your potential. And be aware that I am watching. Now, proceed into the center of the circle to begin. Good luck.
This is not the time for idle chatter. The trial is at hand. But a very few may reach the rank of sir. We have a responsibility. You must step into the circle. Then, good luck.
The first phase of the trial is complete. Proceed further, initiate.
Another cave. How interesting. Ah, a waterfall. That's lovely.
What
in blazes to water? The details are exquisite. You obviously know them well. Something is terribly wrong. Ahead, I sense another's presence in the trial. Dissonance? Growing?
Thank you.
Where am I? What is this place? This place reeks of splintered magic, crafted, cut, and spun from broken threads. I tire of these endless prisons and these paltry games. Begone!
Such power! One moment we were linked, sustaining the magic of the trial, and then an arc of energy, the likes of which I have never seen, burst from you. Three mages lay dead, and two have fled screaming. I know the trial is not meant to be shared, but what in Lyria's name happened? Masked in shadow? I will need to consult my books. Perhaps later we can discuss the details. For now, we have dead to bury and missing mages to find. As for the formalities, you have proven yourself worthy in the trial of initiation. In the name of the Scholia Arcana, I hereby confer unto you the title of Neophyte. Welcome to the Order. Come speak to me when you're ready to be of use. Oh, right. I am after your initiation trial. Wherever he may be, I hope he... Priest, if you're interested in the detail, follow... As for what may be causing the recent... It does... From the... But now... I can't have... They frequent places they believe blessed by Vrakor. Good fortune.